Well, how you doing? This is Elite RC. Last weekend, I ran the car. Basically, got wet, ran through a lot of water, and just pretty much had rained outside. So the burns in the trunk, I went to move my wheels a couple of days later, and the wheels would not move. The burns in the transmission, I had two of those, pretty much had set, rusted. In the inside, some of the balls started to stick, you know, rust out. I opened it up, I did my my burn method on it. I did the other side of the axles, and this is the last side. I said I decided to make a video because I'm pretty sure this don't just happen to me. Let's go and get to it. Let me show you my process on unrusting the burns and re-oiling them and getting them where they need to be to where you won't have future problems out of them also. Let's get to it. Put the gloves on. First, we gotta take the set pin out. Also, twist it up. Get that out the way. Also, you take just basically take the drive shaft off. Just move it out your way. It's the drive shaft. Have old grease on both sides, so it's time to wipe that down and remove the grease and re-grease the dog bones. Alright. So let's try and do the hard part. Get the set pin out and also get this pin out of here. Oh yeah, release it bad. So three. Wasn't that tight at all from the looks of it. Let's see. A little better angle on that. See that? That's what I'm talking about. Fucking screws are all wet and rusted. I have to wipe that down and oil the screw when I get done. Oh yeah. That to the side. Okay, now for the hard part. Let's see. Okay. Basically, the way this axle extender set up, at the bottom down here, it screws in at the bottom. It's not one of those set pins because the wheel sit on this, so you gotta have this screw on, and it takes it off right here. That's right on now. And the wheel extender comes right on off. And now, all of that is dry, rusted. Pop that right on out. Pretty much, I'm gonna wipe this down and oil this also. before I put it back together. I'm gonna do both burns just to show you my method. First thing first, let me get my drill, take this apart. We got all four screws off. Take this apart. Get this up off of it. Put it to the side. Get all the dirt up out of it. Nothing wrong. Get some to knock this bad boy out of it. Burn got a little rust ring on the outside of it. We gonna get all that together. Oh, damn, burn locked up too. Who knows how long I've been losing performance with these burns? It's worse. Who knows? This one's fine, but at the same time, so the inside burn, it's got a little lube on it from the grease from the dog bones. It's fine, but you don't just do one, we do all, we redo things. Get another paper towel real quick. Get a clean canvas to work on. Next time I'm back ready to run like this, I'm gonna take all of these apart from the get-go because these gotta have lube in them. Or they're going, as soon as they get wet, they're gonna run dry on you. And when they run dry, it ain't gonna be any fun. clean this up. Put that to the side. All right, now you got your two burners. I get them to zoom in on this. First I do is wipe them down, try to clean them off as good as I can. And I use full synthetic two-cycle oil for this. Like that. It's not moving at all. I don't know if you can see this, but locked up. You don't see that moving. Then this other one's not locked up. See it? It's moving freely. But we gonna work on both of these. First I'm gonna pop the seals off of both sides. So my little trusty little pick that I like to use. One side. Now sometimes I like to leave, I like to work, matter of fact, that's exactly what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna work one side at a time on both of these. Therefore, the oil can sit there and collect in the burners. So we're gonna work one side at a time. A lot of people just go out and buy new burners. I don't. Just gonna clean out that burn. Like this burn has so much scrub in. I got one of them totally dry, and one of them has too much grit in it. It's not even, I wouldn't even say lube. It's the grease breaking down out of the off of the dog bone, and just coming straight through the seal, getting wet. No, got my two cycle. Got my cast in there, 2.7. Two cycle oil. All I do, when you have a locked up burn, like on this first one, remember the first one's locked up. So you just come in, go around it. Put you in the four squirts. Come to the next one. All around it. Remember how this one was locked up. It was locked up at first. Just move it back and forth, back and forth. It's starting to break loose. It's starting to go freely. There it is. Unlocked. Cast the 927. I just move it back and forth. Now I'm gonna add a little bit more. I just want to break it loose first. I like about it gets that rust, gets all of that out of there. One thing about also about the Castor 927, it's a thick two cycle oil, and it leaves. Get more of that nut so it moves freely. Yeah. Yeah, it's a thick two cycle oil, and it leaves around a film of a oily film that keeps everything lubricated. That's why I use the Castor 927 for this application. Now, since I got my caster in there, done with that. I'm gonna do it on this other one too. This one's already pretty much lubed up because the grease breaking down and getting wet in here. Now for my next step, what I call my secret weapon. Good old graphite lubricant, but it's basically graphite powder. Graphite powder, you come in here. Remember, this is a powder, this is not a liquid. Shake it on here, all different parts of the burn. What this does, when it mixes with that oil, just makes everything pretty much glad. And since they're sealed, it stays around. And I take this, after I put the powder on her, spin it around, get it inside of those ball burns. Let it mix with that oil. To this side also. I do that, press on top of it, get the excess away. After that, pop the seals back on. That seal on that one, seal on that one. That's that side. Now flip it over and you do the same thing, same step. All my 8 scale, when I was doing electrics, my 8 scale buggies and my 10 scale short course trucks. Every time it got wet, I would always have a problem with the burn. So it got to the point to where I wasn't gonna replace them. I started popping the seals off. Popping the seals off, freeing them up, and cleaning them. freeing them up, lubing them up, clean them, put them back in. And they be what I call better than new, because when they come to you new, they come pretty much dry and freely. So as soon as they get wet, that's why they lock up so quick. After you do this process, even when it get wet, you will not have an issue with them. Not off the back. Take your burn, spin it. When you spin it, it gets that oil moving around in those ball burns. I'm gonna get as much excess off as you can. And with your graphite powder. After this, every time I run it, it's kind of damp outside. From here on out, I'm gonna check my wheel burns out. Because you can't tell if some of these are locked up in the car until you pull them out. And you could be getting robbed of your power because the wheel is not spinning freely. It's actually going against what you're trying to do. Pop the seal back on. Pop the other seal back on. And now take a towel and fully clean them up. A fully clean burn on both sides. Got all the rust off. And I'm gonna also grease inside the plastic where it pops in it. That's another one. Fully clean. And the reason why I do the Castor 927, like I said, at least it's known to leave behind an oily residue. It usually coats the motor. But it also, since you're talking metal, does the same thing for your wheel burns. This we're also going to do. listening to these dog bones. See, I got all that old grease on them. And maintenance and stuff like this, you want to always remove the old stuff and put some fresh Wilburn grease on it. It's one dog bone clean. Got the set screw. Try to move this around. Still tight. Not gonna even worry about it. Other side of the dog bone. Move the crud off of the boot. Boot's still in good condition on these. Good, let me know how to use one. Clean this side. Dog bone's still in real good condition. I hear a click. That needs to be tightened up with a 2mm on top. Take it. 2mm set screw to the top of it. Set it, position it. Just tighten them up. I don't need to take it off. That's my dog bones on both sides, clean and ready to be reapplied with more Wilburn grease. I use the Pennzoil Premium Wilburn grease for all my grease jobs, transmission, all of that. Wilburns inside of the diff case, you know, on the diff gears and all of that. Good stuff. Apply with a toothpick. So now you see I got these plastic pieces back out. Still riding with these. I haven't bought any new hubs yet. These are plastic hubs. Go on the rear. Oh, really? Gotta clean these out. These bad boys are dirty. Brush. It's gonna need a little more height on it. I just wanted to focus on the bottom. For the Wilburn cleaner. Kind of stuff in here. Get your pick. Do your fine tuning. So now we're going to reassemble all of this. As a matter of fact, before I reassemble all of this, let me give everything a good spraying. I'm a all-purpose blaster oil. Let me zoom out on this so we can get everything in the frame, picture. Since this is thicker, I'm gonna pull it back here. I'm gonna spray it down. fresh burns I just did. I'm gonna spray those down. Spray them just to get lube on the outside. Then I'm gonna dry them a little bit because I'm not trying to have it lube. Really, I mean, this blaster penetrate the inside. It's basically penetrating oil. I'm not really looking for that application from it. Just want all the outsides to be nice and oiled. Okay, see, now I'm nice and oiled. All right, let's get this back together. So, let's press both of the burns back in. Shit, snap right on in. I shouldn't need my vise. Yeah, snap right on. Yeah, both of them went right on in with no issues. It's facing the rear. That. I'm gonna also gotta put my screws back into it. Got my hands off. Both of those. Let me find my 3mm. Make sure I get a little hand tight. I always hand tight with a turn. Let's flip this over. Clean the canvas. So this comes from right back here. Push it in like that. No problem. Nice and free. And you want to come in. First thing first, set screw. Well, I do it last, because it's part of the last step anyway. Let me put this back on. Give a little zoom to the camera. Put this piece on. It's got the right side. Two and a half. Tighten Got it in there. Wait for it to stop. Boom. Nice and smooth. Don't need a Loctite for some fact. A Loctite set screw right in here. Remember, set screw is nice and rusty. So we're gonna take the penetrating oil, spray it, then wipe it down. That boy right here was just sitting there collecting water. Let's see if I got another one. I don't really want to use this. Matter of fact, I'll be right back. Let's see if I got another one of these, because I pretty much got it. Got it nice and cleaned up. You know what? That'll work. That'll work. Let me make sure I get all the oil off of. From a Permatex thread locker. I use blue. I got some red, but I never use it. I always have a hard enough time getting the blue stuff to break loose, let alone trying to deal with something red. Just a little bit. Got the screw dropped in there. I just basically hand tighten it. You know what I'm gonna do? Let me get a wrench. I do need to put a little torque on it.
That don't fit.
Not going to fit. So since it's not going to fit, I said, you just want a little torque on it. There we go. Still free. Way, way better. Right now, I'll show you how to do my dog bones. And my Q-tip and grease. And I basically just grease the ends. That's all it takes. And after you do that, cover it up with the boot. On the other side, do the same thing. Finished doing what I was doing before I discovered something. I had to make sure I had that pin up there tightened. Basically after that, cover that one up too. This one, put that back in here, this. Make sure it locks in and the lip locks in the inside. That's in. And turn it, come back out on it so you can see where we started from. See, now I got the dog bone back in with the boot. It's ready to get right, it's ready to get back installed on the car. Turn it freely. And that's my, that's what I do. I got my, put my caster 927 in a squeeze bottle, pop the seals, pour it in there, spin it, break it loose, or just regular maintenance if you want to do that. Because once you got this in here, you're not going to have the problem off, and you might have to come back to it. Depends on how heavy you run your vehicle and how, what conditions. If you run in wet conditions all the time, you want to at least mess with it. One, I would mess with it once a month or every 2 months, or when you notice you have an issue. Then after you get that done, go with the next step. That's your graphite powder. It's black. Put a black graphite powder in and spin that also. This mix with this is a real slick combination. And when it leaves a residue, they don't dissipate. So basically, that's what I do with my wheel burns. And burning spirit on the vehicle, all of them, whatever I feel like they're, like I just did all of them, pretty much all the ones from the one on the pinion gear holder, the spur gear holder. I did the ones in the transmission, all of them. I also did the two rear axle ones. So that's my whole drive line, except the fronts. The fronts seem to be fine. I'll go into them another time. Once again, it's Elite RC with how to free up rusted out wheel bearings and how to maintenance wheel bearings with a caster 927 graphite powder.